Turn it off. Wannabes. Okay, today was the official release of Now and Then by the Beatles. Are they claiming the last ever Beatles song? I think that's what they're talking about, isn't it? And I thought, well, you know, if you followed my channel for any length of time, you know that I kind of like the Beatles. I wouldn't call myself a historian of the Beatles. I don't delve into everything, but I've done a few videos on the Beatles, done some location videos, and they are the inspiration for my kind of music, my taste. So they factor a lot in my life. And I suppose if there was a songbook, you know, if I had a kind of like a track list of songs, then the Beatles figure highly in that. But I thought to myself, you know, today's the release of Now and Then. Shall I put my thoughts together? What are my thoughts on the song? Now, I've heard the song. The production is brilliant. I can't fault it. Peter Jackson's AI transformation thing, whatever it is, that extracts John Lennon's vocals from that cassette tape and then allows the production team to layer new instruments is really phenomenal. They've done such an exceptional piece of work. And the song itself sounds so fresh and new. And for that, I think, you know, thumbs up. I may well get flamed for this, but it doesn't move me. The song doesn't move me at all. And I've listened to it a couple of times now, and I won't be putting it on repeat. I won't be putting it, you know, on a selected list of songs in the car. Maybe it's the genre, maybe it's too kind of middle of the road, I'm not sure. But I think my main objection, and this is where I'll get flamed, but it is subjective. You know, you've got your helter-skelter revolution, you know, raunchy Beatles that people love and who will dismiss Martha, My Dear. And I flip it the other way and I go, well, I like Martha, My Dear, but I don't really care for helter-skelter. So that's where the subjectivity comes in. This is unscripted, by the way. I'm just laying my thoughts down. But for Now and Then, It kind of to me is a bit wishy-washy, and I think it doesn't factor up there with the great songs from the catalogue of the Beatles. And I kind of wonder, okay, Free as a Bird, Real Love, yes, they had a cassette with John, they had three songs, they ditched Now and Then because George thought it was crap, so they didn't work on it because of the you know, the camaraderie thing of the Beatles, that if all four of them liked it, they would do it. If one objected, they wouldn't do it. So in this production, what we've got is John's vocal from a cassette. Now, in the 12-minute documentary that was released a day before the song, Sean Lennon's voice is heard saying that he has recollections of his father singing into a cassette recorder and that Yoko had these cassettes. It begs the question, are there more songs? Are there more songs that now that Peter Jackson's technology is available, they can strip out John's vocals? Getting all tongue-tied here. But for me, this is a John Lennon song. Now, he recorded it post-Beatles, just, you know, doing demo. If he'd have taken that song and decided, you know, after Double Fantasy had been released, to say, I've got a whole bunch of songs on a cassette, I think I'm going to go and rework them, then it would have gone to studio, it would have been released on a future album with John at piano and John singing, but with a collection of different musicians. You may well have had Klaus Voormann on bass. So to take his vocal out of that cassette and then offer it up and say, this is a Beatles song, because Paul's playing bass, probably piano, he's doing the guitar. George's original guitar work is said to have been included, because they did do some work on it for the anthology. How much of that is buried now in this new production begs the question, is actually George involved in the making of the song? So we've got Paul and George, we've got an orchestra, we've got Giles Martin doing production, and to make the Beatles as a group, you kind of need George Martin, right? So, okay, production's different. Is it a Beatles song? I personally don't think so. I think it's like John's song with a bunch of session musicians, two of whom happen to be Paul and George, Paul and Ringo. Told you it was unscripted, didn't I? Now, if you take something like Gaucho by Steely Dan, 1980, brilliant album, I love that music. Not so long ago, they found a cassette tape containing one song that was left off the main album, Gaucho. And the reason they left it off was because a technician had scrubbed the tape, and the only version they had was on a cassette tape. And then it was filed away, put in a drawer, never recorded again. They found the cassette, they reworked it, re-engineered, it's now flooded the internet. And it sounds like this. Then I run to the second arrangement. And to me, that's saying, well, here's Steely Dan, and here's a song they collaborated together with to make, but it never got released. And now we can release it. So it's almost like saying, are there any other Beatles songs tucked away somewhere that we haven't heard that we could resurrect and say, this is the last Beatles song? Because it's all four of them in the studio together. It was 1968, it was 1969, whatever it may be. Take the new technology and reproduce it. Oh, that would be sublime. But to take now and then a cassette of John demoing on a piano and then layer them. Okay, you can't dismiss the superb work that's gone into it to make it sound so good. And it does. It sounds really good. But my personal opinion is it's not a Beatles song just because Paul and Ringo and George have collaborated on it. So that's my kind of take on Now and Then. I probably won't be listening to it much. Maybe have a refresher. What did you think? Did you like it? Did you have you listened to it yet? Is it worth? No, that's a wrong question, isn't it? Just did you like it? Drop a comment, let me know your thoughts. Tell me I'm wrong, and I probably am. But again, it's subjective. It's what I think in terms of my choice, my kind of desire of what I want to listen to. And it makes me think that that isn't one of them. So, no hype. I'm not hyping it up. Okay, that was just a quick ramble on Now and Then. Well done, for putting it out there. Lots and lots of people. I've been looking at the comments on the official video, and people are talking about, I never thought I would have a proper new Beatles release in my lifetime. So we're talking a younger generation who are listening to the Beatles that weren't around. I was born in the 60s. I remember my father playing the Beatles on the radio. O bloody oh blada coming off the radio in the car, and we're all going, oh bloody oh blada, life goes on. So I was around as a kid when the Beatles were, and in my teenage years, Wings, Lennon, Harrison, and Ringo, the music flooded. So I've been around. But this new younger generation who weren't around when the Beatles were in existence are hearing this and are praising it because it's a Beatles release in their lifetime. Kind of brings them closer to what the Beatles were. And I can't disrespect that. That's a, it's great. But yeah, not a bad tune. 6 out of 10 for me. If we're going to rank it up there, how about an album? Do a whole album then with different genres of music. We know the Beatles gave out lots of different styles of music. There must be tons of McCartney demos that never made it, that of George Harrison's. And George had said, this clip. I hope somebody does this to all my crap demos when I'm dead. Make them into hit songs. I couldn't remember it off the top of my head, but I knew he'd said something. Okay, I will. That's it. Let's stop there. Unscripted, just my thoughts. And yeah, I've been busy. I've been doing my drama. We've had the Storm Kieran Kirion's, I can't say it. And so we've had to cancel tonight's show, which I'm gutted about. You'll have seen my previous video, which, you know, it's just some footage of us rehearsing for the play. So last performance is tomorrow. But, gave me an opportunity to just spout my thoughts on Now and Then. Okay, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching. See you in another video. And there will be another one soon. Got some Beatles ones lined up. And another Pride and Prejudice. So, ooh.